Right, so we're talking about important things today. Today, we're talking about stock. This is stock. Now, we're going to talk about stock and we're talking about base. There's a difference between stock, base, bullion. We'll talk about all that now. So, in a restaurant, you have options. Escoffier said, you are as good as your stock. And that's partially true. The base of every single one of your dishes is exactly that, your base. So if you have a good stock, everything that you put on top of it will taste good. Now, if you're in a restaurant, we know we do this with bones. Okay, you're going to take the bones and you're going to slap some tomato sauce on them, season them with a little salt and pepper, and you're going to put them in the oven to roast at 450 degrees until they're charred. And then you're going to pretty much boil them. Of course, I wouldn't. I would simmer them with a bouquet garni. We'll talk about that at a later date. But for now, what you need to know is the importance of stock and how stock, without it, your dishes will be missing something. They'll be missing something called depth. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to make stock. Now, if you run out of stock, base is okay in a pinch. In a pinch, mind you, it's not something you want to get used to, because it's very easy to buy a container the size of this of base that'll last months, you know? So don't go lazy. The food purveyors make it easy for you to go lazy. In fact, they want you to. It's like you're walking into Walmart, you know? And then you got all these things, and then just before you leave, you gotta get through the candy and the magazines, and you know, if you need a lighter or if you need you know, a snack on the way out, to give you an example. It's the same thing. Same thing. So stock first, base in a pinch. You don't want to use bouillon. It's pure salt. Okay. So make your stock. My advice is to make a good stock, seasoned without salt. Season it with everything else except salt. You're going to reduce that in your dishes, so you're going to need to be able to adjust the salt as you go. And if it's already salty, it's going to make your dishes salty. That's why base is good in a pinch, because base is already salty. I mean, you can buy it without the salt, but it's also half a flavor. Now, when using stock, I recommend that you have in your station next to you a container of stock with a ladle at the proper temperature. Now, the way we can do that is with a soup insert, you know, 2-3 gallon soup insert. You have it sitting on a stove, and it could be at temperature, you know, waiting for you. Put a ladle in it, and you're just waiting. You get it, and you ladle it into your dish as you need it, and it stays there, and it's just waiting to be used. If you have base, you're going to do the exact same thing. You don't want to mix your base as you go. You're going to mix a proper base, taste it, make sure it's okay, so that you don't adjust things wrong as you go. And you're going to do the same thing. You're going to put it in a soup insert and you put it next to you on the griddle or on the stove or whatever it is that you got. And you're just going to ladle it into your skillets or whatever you're doing in it. Okay? But your best bet always is to make your own stock. The last thing you want to do is get caught in using bases all the time, because, hey, listen, it's easy, okay? And easy is a problem, because they have everything. Think of your food purveyor as walking into Walmart or a Costco or something like that. They literally have everything that the other places have, just in a larger volume, plus the stuff that we get for restaurants, you know. So yeah, you're gonna have to bypass the cheesecakes and the you know, and your favorites that you have to get through, you know, when you get through in the supermarket. Yeah, because they're all there. They're just different quantities, different purveyors, and a lot of them are better. So now, back to the stock. I cannot emphasize enough, and this will be the last time I say it, the second most important thing in your kitchen is your stock.